My name is Yasmine Kotturi. I'm a PhD student at Carnegie Mellon University and a member of the Teaching Systems Lab here at MIT. I became a designer when the design lab opened at UC San Diego. Don Norman returned and started the lab with Scott Clemmer and Jim Holland, and it was the first time that I saw the process of design thinking from people that I really admired and respected. And what I liked about the process was how throughout the entire way, throughout the entire iteration, it's constantly about going out into the world, finding those observations, coming, prototyping, testing, iterating, incorporating user feedback, and continuously going through this cycle, each time figuring out, am I still on the right track? Am I addressing the need that I think I am addressing, for instance? And really this sort of self-awareness that's built into this loop, I think, is really powerful. Prototyping to me is a communication style. It's really this way of taking all of the amazing ideas that we have in our head and putting them out into the world to be able to share them with other people and get feedback on them. And I think the key insight with prototyping is that it's very cheap, it's very fast and easy. And although it's simple, that doesn't mean it's any less valuable necessarily. And so really trying to use prototyping as a way to share your ideas with the people around you. And not only does this allow them to give feedback and to see what it is that you have inside your head, but also to be able to then take it the next step forward to concretizing your solution. A few simple prototyping techniques are sketching, storyboarding, paper prototyping, wireframing, and actually physical prototyping. Sketching is the lowest fidelity way of prototyping, and generally when I sketch, I use a whiteboard, something that is easily erasable, and I can be very dynamic in how I am putting those solution ideas that I developed in the imagine stage out into the real world. And generally what I use sketching for is to get feedback from those people around me, like my colleagues, friends, and peers, to be able to figure out what it is I should focus on in the next stage of prototyping of storyboarding. Storyboarding embodies the narrative aspect of prototyping, where you're showing what the story is of how someone would be interacting with the solution idea that you're developing. Paper prototyping is really powerful because it allows your users, peers, anyone who you ask to give feedback on your paper prototype to be able to step by step go through the solution idea that you have in your head. And it's a really great way of communicating what it is exactly that you're envisioning to address the original need. A wireframe is a slightly more high fidelity version of a paper prototype, where you're focusing not only on the step-by-step interaction that a user will have with your solution idea, but also some of the more aesthetic levels as well. It's helpful to build a physical prototype when your solution idea will be a physical product. So for instance, in the 1960s, Doug Engelbart developed, as he was building the mouse at Xerox PARC, he developed over 60 different, or maybe it was even 100 different physical prototypes of a mouse, all slightly different shapes and sizes, because the very important thing with a mouse is how the user's hand interacts with it. So that type of physical interaction is one of the key aspects he was designing for, thus a physical prototype was necessary. One of the projects that I worked on at the Teaching Systems Lab was a peer feedback system. And to begin, I sketched out a lot of ideas on whiteboard and large sheets of paper to be able to generally see what this peer feedback system could look like. And from there, I transitioned to storyboarding, which I have in front of me here. And so to begin with storyboarding, what I did was I folded a paper in half and then again three times across to be able to, when unfolded, have six really easy and even different panels, all of which, as you can see, have a different section in my storyboard. And at the top of the storyboard, what I've done is sketched out, just written out generally what's happening in the storyboard, and have added a little picture to go along with what is described above. And as you can see, I have a lot of different storyboards all around. And I tried to, in this prototyping stage, refine a few of the ideas that I originally started out with in the Imagine stage. So while we have about maybe 10 different storyboards here, the original ideas probably started with about 20. And from here, what I did was I posted these storyboards all over my office and asked colleagues to come by and give me feedback on the types of ideas in the actual storyboard. And what I found was generally this this red storyboard, my colleagues generally really saw that this storyboard was addressing some of the needs in this peer feedback system that we envisioned. So from there, what I did is started to move on to one of the more high fidelity stages of prototyping, which is paper prototyping. And what I did was I grabbed a bunch of large index cards and just simply outlined a mobile device. And from there, I was able to think about what are the things that a user would go through in this paper prototype, in this eventual system that we envisioned, step by step. And really quickly and easily, I just sketched out what these steps could look like. And so as you can see here, we have, you know, some really, you know, it's definitely not, we're not going for beauty in this stage. We're going for how can we quick and easily get our ideas out onto paper. And, you know, so don't worry about making beautiful lines and using rulers. That can come in later stages of the design thinking process. And for now, you can see we have little buttons here. So if I click to begin, that would advance to our next to the next page here. And while it can feel a little silly clicking on a piece of paper, and given that, you know, in reality, if we, you know, if we clicked on play and we had this little pop-up here, you know, it can feel a little silly to have this type of interaction with something that is so simple as paper. But I think we should never underestimate the power of paper prototyping to get our ideas out there. And so what I can do now that I have developed my paper prototype, is to ask my colleagues and friends around me and users that I am designing for to start to go through this paper prototype and to give me feedback on what it actually feels like to experience this peer feedback system. ¶¶